The Uganda Bureau of Statistics indicates that between October last year and May this year, inflation has declined on account of steadfast and prudent monetary and fiscal policies. This, coupled with a recovering economy, the Bank of Uganda would ideally be reducing its central bank rate. However, at June's monetary policy reading today, the Deputy Governor, Central Bank, announced the rate would be maintained at 10% on account of external risks.
We still have some uncertainties that we're faced with, and also the current inflation projections remain sensitive to elevated risks. So in other words, we need to ensure that this level of elevated risks are kind of like contained before we begin lowering the CBR. So it is the uncertainties in the context of the elevated risks where we are being very cautious that we don't want to begin lowering the CBR at this time, because if these risks materialize, then it means, right, that we will again be back onto the inflationary trend.
Key among these risks is the Russia-Ukraine conflict and predictable behavior of the global central banks in response to their home inflationary pressures, among others.
It is true that, for example, looking at the global development, there's a lot of uncertainty globally. We don't know to what extent the global central banks, for example, will continue raising their rates because they still have inflation pressures. We don't know to what extent the war in Ukraine will drag on and its impact on commodity prices. We don't know, what we are seeing as global fragmentation, how this will evolve over time. So I think in the horizon you have a lot of uncertainties, and therefore holding a ground to first observe and get more information is really appropriate in terms of monetary policy.
Atigo Ego says this cautionary stance is expected to aid a reduction of inflation to 5% by end of September, and expectations are that it will be maintained at the same rate over the next 2 to 3 years. Story by Benno Jambo for the news.